Very good morning to all the students of class plus 2C beta. So after vacation, you people are coming back to track. Only 30 students have joined and 10 students have not joined so far. One should be regular beta. It doesn't mean that holidays are going on. It's over now, enough of it, and you have to prepare for boards. You know that pattern is changed. Twice you will be having your board exams, and it is quite objective based. You people might be thinking that it's very easy, but no. It becomes difficult to attempt objective questions because there are a lot of options which will confuse you. So the people or the students who have done thorough reading, only they will be able to attempt the test or the exam easily. Fine. Vanshika, now my voice is audible to you. You have joined again. Send me thumbs up for that. Okay, beta. So before you can say I start teaching you, I must tell you, you have to be regular enough. Suppose if you attend this chapter today and tomorrow, you just for the sake of attendance, if you are coming or not listening to the teacher, then it will be your beta loss. So join on daily basis. One chapter is clear to you, at least 5 to 6 marks you are preparing. Okay. So on daily basis, you have to be regular. There are many students who do not join class on regular basis. Fine. So I must be calling the parents in that way if you will do. Okay. So let's start. Without wasting much time, very important chapter we are going to start, that is Indigo. If you won't be, you have to be very, very attentive because this chapter dates back to pre-independence era and we would be, understanding exactly those who are texting me, beta, those who are unable to hear my voice, they can rejoin. I'll again admit you. You check network on your part, keep the windows open so that there is no problem of network issues and all, okay? So first of all, what is Indigo? The name of the chapter is Indigo. And if anybody of you knows what is the meaning of Indigo, you can raise hand, I will unmute you. Okay? Nobody knows. Okay, let me tell you what is indigo. Actually, indigo is a beta plant which is used for commercial purpose. Fine. It is used, actually, you can say the plant is used to obtain a blue colored dye. You might have seen your mothers going for getting the dupatta dye and all that. But these days, various colors are available. Fine. But it's a kind of dye only. Yes. Rasika is saying plant for blue coloring. Yes. The color of clothes. Very good. Fine. Vanshika and Rasika, they are sending me answers in the chat box. I would be speaking the names, those who are actively participating. So it's a plant for a blue colored dye, you can say. And that dye is obtained from that plant. Fine. So you can say indigo is a commercial crop. Anybody can tell me what are the staple crops or staple foods of our Punjab? Staple foods of Punjab. Anybody, you can type in the chat box, wheat. Very good. Vanshika gave quick answer. Vaibhav is saying wheat. Amarpreet is, wheat is there. Yes, Vanshika. Very good. Rice. So wheat and rice being staple crops and staple foods. Very good. Now stop texting. So we all know that we people, Punjabi especially, they are known for eating wheat and rice. And there are less number of commercial crops. So the chapter I already told you dates back to pre-independence era, where I would be introducing the characters to you and the storyline also, then you will be able to relate. And actually we'll get to know that how India got independence. It is not only one man's army. It is not the efforts of only one person. We till date, we just know about Bhagat Singh, how he just, you can say, being a rebellious persona, how he made his efforts, and how Gandhiji, being very patient persona, how he put in his efforts in making India free. But, you know, behind the stage, there are many people who were actually working tirelessly, who were at least aware that how to raise voice against Britishers. When you are, you know, not raising your voice, that is the problem. That's why we could not get independence before 47. People were not aware. They were illiterate. They were not educated. They were not getting good leaders who can evoke responses out of them. Fine. So Rajkumar Shukla, the protagonist, I have written Shukla here, but I have written the name of character. So I would be introducing the characters first. I told you the background dates back to pre-independence era. So I can ask any one of you, stay there only. Fine. Now the characters. Firstly, the protagonist is Rajkumar Shukla. Who is Rajkumar Shukla? He is a poor sharecropper from Champaran. Now, Champaran is the name of a district. The way you live in Jalandhar district, he used to live in Champaran district in Bihar, Motihari. Fine, you'll get to know the details in the chapter only. And then, though he was illiterate, Rajkumar Shukla, though he was poor, and he was a sharecropper. Now, the point comes, what is a sharecropper? You might have heard about farmers, peasants, fine? It's a synonym only, fine? Now, sharecropper are the ones, sometimes farmers, they do have their own land where they grow crops. But many a times, they do not have any own land also. They just take land on rent. And then they grow crops, and after the production, whatever they sell out, and then they gain benefits, and then they pay rent for that. They become the sharecroppers because they have to, you know, sometimes keep the share of their production also as a rent. So that's why we call them sharecroppers. The difference is clear to you? Send me thumbs up quickly. I'm just checking those who are listening. Who's a sharecropper? Send me thumbs up. Yes, quickly. Very good. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 10, 12. Very good. 13. Palak is there. Apoorv is there. Fine. So I'm just seeing by sending thumbs up those who are sitting and listening to me. Those who won't be sending thumbs up, they are absent from me. Fine. So make sure you're sending thumbs up. I'm able to see on the screen. So sharecropper, those who grow crops and they have to give the production, or you can say they have to give the rent in easy language. Now, Rajkumar Shukla, though he was very poor sharecropper, illiterate, but some people are very, you can say, aware about their rights. They do not, you know, let others to suppress them. And Rajkumar Shukla was one aware citizen, you can say, one aware peasant. Most of the peasants, whatever British people were asking them, before it is set in, before independence era. So Britishers were there, obviously, the rule was there. Whatever they were saying, whatever they were doing, poor people, they have to follow them. Fine. But Rajkumar Shukla, he just wanted to raise voice against them. And then he heard about Gandhiji, M.K. Gandhi, Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi. That's why I have written M.K. Gandhi. His full name, fine, in the abbreviations I have written, Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi. At that time, Gandhiji was well known. He was not known as a father of nation at that time, because till date, anybody has not got that independence, fine. So Gandhiji was an advocate, you can say, by profession. He had, in those times when people were not even literate, he completed his law. He pursued law from foreign countries. He was well aware and he was working for the welfare of people. So he was known as one of the leaders who was working well for the welfare of the people only. So everybody was knowing that a very lean and thin man is there who wears very simple dress like dhoti and all. And he's helping many people of the country here and there. And he keeps on doing meetings. He keeps on creating awareness and that sort of thing. Fine. So Rajkumar Shukla heard of that leader, M.K. Gandhi, and he thought, I should meet this man at least. All alone, I can't do anything. With the help of this man, I would be raising my voice. Fine. Third character is servants at Rajendra Prasad's house. I would be telling you this character later on because their entry is a bit late. Maybe we won't be able to reach till that point. Now, what I'm going to cover today, Rajkumar Shukla, poor sharecropper, you can note down, beta, points side by side. They will help you in understanding the chapter in a better manner, okay? Characters and value points. See, I have written one quote also. That quote actually matches with the theme of the chapter. Hard work never goes unrewarded. Many a times people say, I have put in a lot of efforts, but I have not got fruits accordingly, results accordingly. But no, sooner or later, definitely your hard work pays off. It will never go wasted. Fine. So that quote matches with the efforts made by Rajkumar Shukla and Gandhiji. So with this efforts, actually this incident set base for India to get independence. So this chapter Indigo is very important for you people to know. Clear? Shukla is a poor sharecropper from Champaran. He wishing to meet Gandhiji. So he wanted to meet Gandhiji, and Gandhiji was not easily available. At that time, he was such a known leader who would, you know, go from one place to another, sometimes in Kanpur, Lucknow, Delhi and all, Purani Delhi. Fine. So he would visit places to solve the problems of various people. But it was not easy to meet him. He was a known leader. He went to Rajendra Prasad's residence. So meeting Gandhiji finally, after a lot of efforts, you know, the people who have awareness like Shukla, they will not leave any stone unturned to meet their ends. So he did all the efforts. He put in all the efforts to meet Gandhiji. Wherever Gandhiji was going, he was following him. And one day Gandhiji just noticed that this man, wherever I go, in whatever city I reach, he just follows me and he keeps on waiting for hours to meet me. Then he gave a chance to Shukla that, okay, let's meet me at this place, at this time, on this date, then we will decide. So when Gandhiji meets him, he was not aware that Rajkumar Shukla is a man of caliber, aware peasant and sharecropper, who's going to raise voice not only for himself, but also for all the peasants, all the farmers, all the sharecroppers from Champaran district. Clear? So then Gandhiji started that revolution after meeting him. They went to Rajendra Prasad's residence. Who's Rajendra Prasad? Anybody can tell me if you have heard this name. Who is Rajendra Prasad, beta? You can answer me in the chat box. Yes. No one knows. You might be searching here and there. First president, Rasika says. Yes. Fine. First president. Yes, Suhani is saying. So Rajendra Prasad is that first president of India. Gandhiji was a man of principles. He thought, I will not start searching or digging into the matters straight away after meeting Shukla. I would be going into the details. So he went to Rajendra Prasad's house, residence. He then decided to go to Muzaffarpur to get detailed information. Fine, we would be knowing about the places in this chapter only. And now why the chapter is named Indigo? Because very simple and innocent peasants, they were forced to grow indigo. I already asked you the staple crops of India mainly, and Punjab and India, you can say, they are rice and wheat. And at that time, people would grow rice and wheat firstly for their own use, and then after for selling purposes and fulfilling their needs. Fine, but poor peasants and innocent peasants were forced to grow indigo, that crop, that commercial crop, which produces a blue color dye. And not only that, beta, they were forced to grow indigo. You can say along with that, they were forced to give 15% of share to the Britishers also. Find that whatever they have grown, 15% of that part, they have to on 15% of, you can say, the ground, they have to grow indigo. And after growing indigo, they have to give the production that also, whatever they have grown, that plant, they have to give the production as a rent to the Britishers. Fine. So they were actually befooling the innocent peasant. Fine. And not only that, in the meantime, when they started forcing them, they started asking them to sign on papers, or they were not able to sign, they were just using their thumb impressions and all. In the meanwhile, Germany started producing cheaper indigo, synthetic indigo. Britishers thought, why we are forcing these stupid farmers to grow indigo? Let's move to Germany. Let's ask them to send us synthetic indigo plant, which is very cheaper. Fine. So they started importing indigo from Germany, and they asked the farmers, the sharecroppers, that because we have started taking indigo from Germany at cheaper prices, that now you are responsible for this. You have to give compensation for this. See what a stupid agreement it is, that you have to give compensation because you have wasted that 15% production. See, till now, if any point is not clear, you can ask me, beta, any one of you. Is it clear? Send me thumbs up. Clear to all of you? Yes. I can ask any one of you then. Anmol, kindly unmute you, beta. Anmol?
Yes.
Yes, beta. What is indigo?
Ma'am, indigo, we can say, एक second. माने plant होता है जिसके through हम dye कर सकते हैं कपड़ों को, मतलब we can dye the clothes ना.
It's a deep blue dye. Actually, you won't give the introduction as a plant. Maybe I have, maybe slip of tongue was there. It's a blue colored dye. The exact definition is obtained from a plant. Fine, that is called indigo. So you can say this is used for commercial purpose. Nice. Okay, you can mute yourself. Now, Harnoor saying, kindly unmute yourself. I won't be asking difficult questions. Don't worry. Harnoor saying, kindly unmute you, beta. See, those who are not unmuting, it means I would be taking that they are not there. And they are absent for me. Mehak, unmute yourself, beta. Very easy questions I would be asking. Mehak Vasan. Suhani, unmute yourself. Just tell me the full name of Gandhi.
Yes, ma'am.
Tell me the full name of this M.K. Gandhi.
Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi.
Yes, very good. At least you were paying attention. I'm just saying I would be asking very easy questions. Palak Dhal, can you unmute yourself? Yes, very good. Yes, Palak. Can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, Palak, beta. You just tell me. Who was Rajendra Prasad?
First president.
Very good. Okay. So let's continue now. I just wanted to see whether you are listening to me or not. Yes. Can you see the screens? You're just left with, I guess, 6 minutes. So we would be reading or getting. This is the, you can say, introductory part only. I would be just, we would be able to do this only, I guess, today. Okay. about the author now. It's very important to read about the author, Louis Fisher. Screens are visible to you. About the author, Louis Fisher, 1896 to 1970. He was born in Philadelphia. He served as a volunteer in the British Army between 1918 and 1920. Fisher made a career as a journalist and wrote for the New York Times, the Saturday Review, and for European and Asian publications. He was also a member of the faculty at Princeton University. The following is an excerpt from his book, The Life of Mahatma Gandhi. The book has been reviewed as one of the best books ever written on Gandhi by Times Educational Supplement. So, Louis Fisher, he just was serving, you can say, British Army between 1918 and 1920. And he was a journalist by profession. Fine, who used to write for newspapers. They have mentioned the names of newspapers, New York Times, Saturday Review and all. And finally, he started writing for magazines and then he wrote his own books also. Fine, he wrote The Life of Mahatma Gandhi because he actually, Louis Fisher actually met Gandhiji when Gandhiji was serving the nation as one of the leaders of the Congress, you can say. Clear? So when he met Gandhi, he asked him how it happened. Now it stands for how India got independence. And then Gandhi gave interview to this man, Louis Fisher. And then after recording his interview, after asking him many questions, he got to know many things about India's independence. Fine. So this is the brief introduction of Louis Fisher. I hope it's clear to all of you. And these expressions, beta, we would be reading in the chapter only. Clear? Whenever they will come, I will tell the meaning of it. When I first visited Gandhi in 1942 at his ashram. Now, who is I here? I is Louis Fisher. Clear? The writer of this chapter. He has written actually the book, The Life of Mahatma Gandhi. And this chapter in class plus two is part or extract of that book, Life of Mahatma Gandhi. Fine? So, Louis Fisher is narrating his experience that when I first visited Gandhi in 1942, see, before independence, and we got independence in 1947. I will tell you how it happened that I decided towards the departure of the British. It was in 1917. So he said, now he here stand for M.K. Gandhiji, fine? I stand for Louis Fisher. He stands for Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi, Gandhiji. Gandhiji said, okay, Louis Fisher, I will tell you how it happened. Means how we got independence. That how I decided to urge means to request the departure of British. And it started in 1917. Make sure you know the dates well. You can get any question. Meeting in this interview is going on 1942. This incident of Indigo, this occurred in 1917. Okay, only 2-3 minutes are left, beta. We would be able to just get basic information. So tomorrow we will be starting from beginning again. He had gone to December 1916 annual convention of the Indian National Congress Party. Okay, these are the details. I will be continuing tomorrow because only 2 minutes are left. So we have read about Louis Fisher only and how he conducted interview with Gandhiji and he just got to know views. Now, from here onwards, we will be continuing tomorrow. He had gone to December 1916 annual convention. So Gandhiji would be narrating his experience of Indigo and meeting Rajkumar Shukla and all the revolution, what sort of incidents followed, and finally what happened to peasants and that crop. Fine, from that, the seed of independence germinated in him. So then he decided, ki, okay, Britishers are befooling our people like anything. This is the high time we should raise our voice. Clear? So any doubts to anyone? Amarpreet is asking, can you repeat sharecropper? Yes, beta, definitely. Sharecropper, beta, you have heard about the peasants or farmers. Fine, that is very easy term. We sometimes call them farmers. Sometimes we use the term peasants, P-E-A-S-A-N-T-S. Fine. Now, sharecropper. they are actually the ones who do not have their own land. They take land on rent and then they start growing the crop over there. And they have to pay the rent to Britishers for that. Fine, at that time. And many middlemen were there, many sahukars were there who were working as mediators between British people and Indian peasants, Indian farmers. Fine, they were extracting money out of innocent farmers. They were giving to Britishers as well as they were keeping with them also. Clear? So who was being suppressed? Indian farmer. Till date, you can see the still at Delhi border, they are sitting, nothing is happening. Till date, farmers are suffering. Fine, that is another story. So you know the meaning of sharecropper is clear. So with this, I'm going to end the meet beta. Time is there. Next period going to start. Okay, join well in time. All the best for your future learnings also. Okay.